Hello student, I am Pooja Pandey. I'll teach you science and technology. Today I'm going to read the first chapter, that is life on earth. You should read along with me. Students, reading is very important homework. You should learn how to read each and every word correctly, and therefore you will have to practice. So this is your reading class. You must read the lesson repeatedly, loudly and very carefully. So let's start, students. Chapter number 1, Life on Earth. In chapter Our Earth of class 6, you had read that all living organisms, plants and animals. So students, hear the word organism means, underline that word organism. Organism means a living thing that has the ability to act or function independently. So here organism means plants and animals. Have three basic requirements. No organism can survive without this. These three essential things are food, water, and air. Okay. Why do organisms need these things? Write in your own words. You may also consult class 6 book. So students, here I give you a project book. So solve this question at your home. Organisms live in different types of environment. Some live on land and some in water. Organisms on land are also of different kinds. Organisms easily get essential things required for living most places on the earth, and they live in such places in large numbers. On the other hand, there are some places on the earth where living conditions are very harsh. So student, harsh. Underline that word. Harsh means hard. Desert is one such place. In the desert, there is sand everywhere and water is scarce. So, there are no shady trees in deserts. And the days are very hot, nights are very cold, as sand gets cold during night. In the same way, in cold regions such as north and south poles and on the peaks of mountains, there is always snow, and these regions are very cold. A very small number of organisms is found in such harsh conditions. You have read about the geographical conditions in your district and state. You know that different types of environment are found in different parts of Chhattisgarh. Some parts of the state are plains. Others have mountains, some have lakes, and some have dense forest. Our country is much bigger than Chhattisgarh. A lot of diversity is found in the environment of our country. India is surrounded by oceans on three sides. And in the north, there are Himalayas, Himalayas is a range of many small and big mountains. Small mountains have dense forests, and the high mountains peaks are covered with snow. A part of Rajasthan is desert. There are vast plains in Uttar Pradesh and Bihar. If we look at the whole earth, we find a greater variety of environments. You would have read that earth has two poles, north and south. Both these poles are very cold and their surface is always covered with snow. Apart from this, huge oceans, vast deserts, dense forest, mountains, plains, etc. are found on the surface of the earth. You know that all organisms are connected to each other through food chains. A food chain always begins with a plant. Can you tell why? Let's now travel around different types of environments and find out the conditions in which plants and animals live, their relation with each other, and from where and how do they get things required for life. Let us first go to the environment most familiar to us, our own surroundings. You would have seen peepal trees growing from the walls of old houses, monuments, etc. These trees get plenty of oxygen from the air for respiration. So here, underline that word, students. That means respiration means breathing, breathe, and carbon dioxide present in the air helps them in making their food. But where do they get water and minerals from? Can you guess it? Can you think of and write a food chain beginning with peepal tree? So students, here I also gave you another project work. Write at your home. You might have seen that often in the grains of wheat and rice, small insects called weevil, means ghoon, are found. These insects easily get air and food, but how do they get water? Lizard, ghoon, and other animals are not seen drinking water because they get sufficient water from the food they eat and thus do not need to drink water. Can you make a food chain in which there is weevil, ghoon? So students, try to find out from where do plants and animals around you get food, air and water. We will now go to the historical city of Jaisalmer in the state of Rajasthan. Jaisalmer is in the middle of a desert. And when we come out of the city, we find sand all around. There are thorny bushes in place of big trees. A tree similar to babool, khejdi, is found in abundance in Rajasthan. Apart from this, cactus means nagfani and Rajasthani grass are also found. These plants are the first links of food chains here. During the day, it is sunny and so hot that no animals can be seen. In the evening, many small and big animals come out in search of food. Desert lizards eat insects walking on the sand, and the rats who make burrows. Burrows means the home of rats in sand, also come out in search of food. Hawks and owls prey on these lizards and rats. Foxes living in this desert also hunt these rats and birds. Many organisms are found even in dry environment like a desert. These organisms are also linked with each other in many ways, forming multiple food chains. Now we will go very far away from our house to the oceans. Oceans have so much water that they never dry up. 3/4 of Earth's surface is covered with seawater and the rest is land. You know that? From this you can estimate how much water is there in the oceans. Many types of algae, small and big plants, keep floating on the surface of the ocean. These plants make food from carbon dioxide dissolved in water in the presence of sunlight. They get water and minerals from the ocean. They respire by taking oxygen from the air dissolved in water. These plants are found in large numbers in the oceans and are the first links of a long food chain. Even big animals living in oceans are dependent on these plants. Small animals swimming in water eat these plants. These small animals are eaten by animals bigger than them and by fish. Smaller fish are eaten by still bigger fish, and then bigger fish are eaten by even bigger fish. Many big and small fishes, mammals and birds are found in the oceanic environment. Smaller organisms are eaten by organisms bigger than them, thus making long food chains, not only the animals in the sea, but other animals living on the shores of the oceans are also dependent on these chains. We will see an example of this later. So students, here the picture of polar bear. Polar bear found in Arctic region and Antarctic region, and their habitat is Arctic region and Antarctic region. After moving around the ocean, we now move to the North Pole, called the Arctic region. This region is so cold that is covered with a thick coat of snow almost all the year round. During summers, for a short time, a part of the snow melts and some small plants and algae grow. Rats, deer and rabbit are the main herbivores animal found in the region. Most of the animals found here are white in color, which makes it difficult to see them. On the white snow, the common carnivorous animals of this region are bear, wolf, fox, and owl bears found in Arctic region are white in color and are huge in size. They are called polar bears. So students, here I'm at this reading video. The rest of this portion of this chapter we will continue of our another video. So thank you so much students. You should read at your home and practice the that words that I underline. Okay, thank you so much.